record was one qualification that got him here, was the apparent absence of one-punch knockout power the other qualification, Roy?
Yeah, I think that definitely was the other qualification. When you bring it up fight home, there are so many other pressures lying on you already. Tickets, who you're going to give tickets to, where they're going to sit. I mean, it's just so much pressure that you got to try to find the easiest way or the easiest task at hand, but still make it competitive, but a good task.
You did this kind of thing many times, fighting around your hometown of Pensacola. Is the first time the toughest?
Yes, the first time is most definitely the toughest.
Max Kellerman, you've seen Martin Murray fight. What are your impressions of what he can do?
Well, he's ordinary in certain ways. He's not blazingly fast. He's not a huge puncher, but he's in his physical prime. He's strong, he's big. He's a legitimate lower echelon top 10 contender. And these conditions, a damp ring, fighting a 38-year-old with coming off a knee surgery who has to deal with all the pressures you mentioned, these conditions might, in a way, favor him.
Martin Murray co-promoted by Ricky Hatton, who has been a popular figure all week here in Argentina. Fight fans couldn't catch a glimpse of Sergio Martinez out and about. He was hidden in his hotel room, but Ricky Hatton was visible in many of the top restaurants around town and remains one of the most popular figures attached to the sport.
And Sergio Martinez has turned into a Ricky Hatton kind of draw. We haven't seen a crowd like this amped up, this energetic, and this jam-packed in a soccer stadium since Ricky Hatton.
I might say it is raining cats and dogs at this moment, even though 5 or 10 minutes ago it appeared that the rain had abated. How big a factor is the environment, the heavy rain, and for these fighters as they get ready to come into the ring, Roy?
Well, it's a big factor for Sergio Martinez, whereas he doesn't want the surface to get too slippery. The least of a slip would cause him re-injuring his knee.
Could that prompt him to take gambles early on?
Yes, it could.
Crowd with a whistling reception for Murray as he comes in, saying hello to Martinez promoter Lou DiBella. And DiBella has been quite frank in saying, I'm worried about my fighter. He's 38 years old. He's had a lot of physical difficulties. This is no red light scene.
And he's a natural junior middleweight, let's not forget Martinez, who had to move up to middleweight for opportunity, not simply because he outgrew the lighter division.
Crowd is not allowing the rain to dampen its enthusiasm. They've been raucously noisy ever since they began to come into this stadium 4 hours ago.
Mark Murray has plastic bags wrapped around his sneakers.
That's what it's all about. Send
them
over.
And now that he's in the ring, the plastic bags are being removed. So Murray now will await the arrival of Sergio Martinez. And of course, it's poetic that Martinez, who was once a professional soccer player, would fight in a soccer stadium upon his arrival back in Argentina. There are many top soccer clubs around Buenos Aires. We asked Sergio, is this the home of the club that you used to root for? And he said, oh, no, this is not my team. This is another team, their rival, but it will still be fun for me. Here he comes. In a situation like this, where the ring walk is something of a coronation, is this yet another distraction, Roy?
Yes, this is another distraction. However, this is a good distraction because it brings you to grips to how these people really feel about you and what they're really expecting out of you. So this is a great distraction.
You look at the rapture on Sergio Martinez's face. He's obviously overwhelmed and soaking it all in. A dream come true to be received as a true superstar in his home country after toiling in obscurity for so many years. The prodigal son's return.
This is a massive city. Many beautiful buildings.
against Chavez that he seemed to connect like this. Boxing fans in particular, yeah, you can be a front runner and better than everyone and beat everyone up, but how do you respond when you get knocked down? He got back up and fought and survived and became a superstar in the process. That was the easy part. Now that he's a star, can he stay a star? Can he stay on top? That's the hard part.
But he still has an edge. He's well aware of the degree to which that 12th round knockdown and the desperate straits in which he found himself have helped to amplify his stardom. But when I finished my sit-down interview with him the other day, and of course part of the feature piece was built around the difficult circumstances of the 12th round, the first thing he said when the camera stopped rolling was, let me ask you this, how come people don't ever ask me about the first 11 rounds of the fight?
Because we knew he could do that. We knew we'd seen it before, but could he do what he did in the 12th? It was an amazing display of championship guts and the will to survive and win. And when you do that, you get a sold-out soccer stadium and fireworks.
Principal de la noche, 12 rondas de boxeo para el campeonato de peso medio del mundo de CMB. 12 rounds of boxing for the WBC Middleweight Championship of the World. Presentado por Luis de Vélez, de Bella Entertainment y Samson Boxing, en asociación con Hatton Promotions. Sancionada por el Federación Argentina de Box, el presidente, señor Carlos Rodríguez. El presidente de CMB, José Suleiman. El supervisor, Mauricio Suleiman. Este evento es patrocinado por Aerolíneas Argentinas y también IPF. The three judges at ringside. Los tres jueces de Estados Unidos, Max DeLuca, de Venezuela, Nicolas Hidalgo, y de México, Alejandro Rochin. And inside the ring, in charge of the action at the bell, el referee de Italia, Massimo Barravecchio. Y ahora, los funcionarios están listos. Los combatientes están listos. Argentinos, estamos listos. Para los miles de asistentes y los millones de personas alrededor del mundo. Damas y caballeros, let's get ready to rumble. En la esquina azul, the blue corner, con su entrenador Oliver Harrison. Official weight, 159.6 pounds. Peso oficial, 72.3 kilos. Como profesional, 25 victorias, con 11 KOs. Y un empate, 25 victories, including 11 knockouts with one draw. He's the fighting pride of St. Helens, Merseyside, England, the WBA interim world middleweight champion, El Retador, El Invicto, the undefeated Martin Power. En la esquina roja, in the red corner, con su entrenador Pablo Sarmiento. Official weight, 159.4 pounds. Peso oficial, 72.3 kilos. Como profesional, 50 victorias, con 28 knockouts, 2 derrotas y 2 empates, 50 victories, 28 by knockout, 2 defeats, 2 draws. Damas y caballeros, presentando el campeón del mundo, peso medio de CMB, the reigning, defending, WBC middleweight champion of the world, de Quilmes, Argentina, Sergio Maravilla.
Remember what I told you in dressing room. No rabbit punch, no headbutt, no low blow. Shake your hands, good luck, suerte.
Good luck.
Binoculars to see that Murray is the larger man. He's a natural middleweight. Martinez, as Max Kellerman pointed out, still a natural 154-pounder functioning as a middleweight. But Martinez has greater speed, greater quickness, and greater punching power. Certainly the greater ability to catch his opponent with something he doesn't see coming.
And the greater pressure to put on a show for these fans after the show they just put on for him.
Scores first with a straight left hand to the chest of Murray. His body punching against Chavez in the early rounds, particularly with the left hand, a tremendous key to the beating he was able to dish out that night.
Posture, and it worked, but Martinez got caught.
Yeah, it worked.
first significant punch of the fight for Murray. Martinez has landed a few body shots early.
One thing Martinez does have to be careful of is landing that straight left hand on Martin's elbow.
Martinez has had problems, it seems, with every part of his body, being a competitive athlete before he ever became a boxer, and then having so many fights against top-notch opposition in recent years.
Well, as you alluded to, he's had a knee surgery since the Chavez fight. His promoter, Ludabella, hints that there are other surgeries yet to come. At 38 years old and fighting in this particular very physical, very mobile, athletic style, you wonder how long it can last. Murray with the peekaboo defense. Martinez trying to pierce it.
Murray, a very good basic fighter. Uses a good jab, good combinations, stays behind his defense, so it should make for a very interesting night.
Martinez has to be content mostly to work to the body in round one, as Murray kept the peekaboo guard up for much of the round.
And then you put your hands in. You're gonna start playing now, don't worry. You're gonna turn them off.
On the nose, okay? You know how to do this. You gotta keep going through the nose. No one raises any confusion doing that to him. Nothing doing that to you, all right? You feel okay? You wanna let them go behind and go to
say? Yeah, not yet. Yeah, yeah. Okay.
Not many punches landed in a pure feeling out first round. Roy Jones, your take.
Well, my take is that Martinez was being smart, showing his power early to try to let Martin know that he has to respect the power, and now he's going to try to work his feints and see can he open him up a little bit. For Murray, he just wanted to be defensive, get a feel for what's going on, see what type of chances he's allowed to take, and now he'll try to come out and take those chances.
I wonder how much already the presence of this crowd and the reception Sergio Martinez has gotten from them has influenced his style early, in that he's dropping his hands right away, trying to egg Martin Murray out of his shell because he wants to give them a show. He's a natural showman.
Monday, Martinez will try to get himself back into a responsible defensive position from this position with the hands down below the waist, and the reflexes won't be there. It hasn't happened yet.
No, and I don't think that'll be the case tonight either. But sometimes, Jim, when you got a guy who fights with his hands high like Martin Murray, you have to show them a target in order to get them to punch at you.
Murray, like everyone else, also saw what happened in the Chavez fight late. And given Martinez's various injuries, they feel that the longer this fight goes, the more Martinez is likely to break apart. Been broken apart in the process.
Martinez fainting. Murray not biting on the feint.
No, he's not biting at all. He's very smart, staying very closed in his offense, not opening up too much to give Martinez an opportunity to counter nothing. He has that winky right style of defense.
isn't coming forward behind it quite yet.
But we've seen Barker do this and Macklin with it. Keep that guard high and try to punch in between Martinez's lightning shots.
Good right hand
lands for Murray. And a right hook for Martinez at the end of the round. May 25 at 6:15 p.m. Don't miss Carl Prott versus Mikkel Kessler from London, England. Later that night, we'll re-air Prott Kessler in conjunction with a live light heavyweight showdown between Jean Pascal and Lucien Boutte.
When you're ready,
yeah.
You understand? Okay.
You saw the copy box numbers from round two. Martinez 10 out of 47. Murray 5 out of 31. The rain is starting to fall very hard again, and it's blowing sideways into the ring. So eventually this canvas is going to be fairly damp. Both men, of course, have rubber soles on their boxing shoes. And the earlier fights we've seen, we have not seen a lot of slipping and sliding and difficulty as a result of the damp conditions.
Still, you would think that Murray's style, he's more of a mutter, as they say in horse racing, than Martinez. And you heard Murray's corner wanting him to get more physical with Martinez.
Murray being very smart here, not taking the bait from Martinez, not trying to swing his head big just because his hands are down.
Martinez wants to have an exciting fight to please the home crowd. Murray's going to make him do it the hard way.
Yes, he is.
Building the fire by himself.
Exactly. He's not taking any chances.
Well, Martinez has that kind of power and speed, and he brings punches from places fighters can't see. So he hurts them. He's very dangerous with one shot. Murray's aware of it.
Martinez just sticking his jab between Murray's gloves over and over, occasionally landing a body shot. Murray gets in another right hand and now misses that one.
And Murray's landing some good body shots here too, Jim.
Now Martinez really kept his head still in the middle there for a second run.
Oh!
Good right hand by Murray.
Yes.
Best punch of the fight so far for the Englishman.
Martinez can't bat straight up with his hands down.
Well, he's showing some frustration in Murray's defense, and he's trying anything to get him to open up, but he's taking some chances here.
He's doing what he has to do to make it entertaining and to try to open Murray up.
Body shots like that.
Good body shot by Martinez. Now Murray comes back with a left hook body shot of his own. I remind you that once this fight's concluded, we will take you to Ontario, California to see the heavyweight battle between Chris Areola and Berman Stubern. Bob Papa and Andre Ward standing by at ringside to call that one there. Terry skirmish. Martinez landed a right upstairs, and Martin Murray got in a body shot. Rain is falling harder than at any time during the night so far. And the forecast was somewhat equivocal all day long as to when this would happen. The only thing we knew for sure was that it would happen at some point.
Everything's all right?
Yeah.
10,000 plus in Jose Amalfitani Stadium here in Buenos Aires getting wet as they watch Sergio Martinez and Martin Murray fighting cautiously through the first three rounds of the fight. In the third round, they threw an equal number of punches and they landed an equal number. Martinez was 10 of 47, Murray was 9 of 46. Overall in the fight, Martinez has landed 27 punches to 17 for Martin Murray.
Rain is really coming in sideways now, drenching us and the fighters.
I haven't seen rain like this at an outdoor prize fight. Lennox Lewis against Frank Bruno in Cardiff, Wales about 20 years ago. That fight ended on a sixth round Lennox Lewis knockout, but he had serious difficulties up to that point. Martin Murray is fighting a very solid, very cautious, very technical fight so far.
He just landed a pretty good right hand before Martinez landed a pretty good left hand.
Trying to play Matador, but he has a somewhat reluctant pull so far.
Right hand by Martinez, good left hand by Murray. Starting to open up and throw a little bit more.
Five times.
But if you're in Murray's corner, that's some of what you want. You want a bruising kind of brawl where Murray starts to impose his size and youth and strength. Low blows and headbutts.
Good left hand by Martinez. Probably the best left hand of the fight for Martinez. Good body shots by both fighters. Starting to get some real contact.
Some hard legal contact.
Well, it's almost as though Murray has arrived in this round as an aggressive force, deciding for the first time to open his guard up a little bit and fight.
He just landed a good right hook against Martinez too.
Martinez, rather Murray, is landing some good flush punches upstairs. That's the third one in the last 30 seconds.
Following the live boxing debut for Real Sport, featuring the profile of Boyd Melson, a boxer who donates all his in-ring earnings to spinal cord research.
Sergio. Come on, that left is going in, coming in. Be careful, Sergio, be careful. Be careful when you're close to him. Careful, careful with his hands. Everything okay? Okay, everything's perfect.
Box numbers for the fourth round that showed that for the first time in the fight, Murray outlanded Martinez, landing 12 of 40 punches in the round. And you heard Martinez's trainer Pablo Sarmiento cautioning him that he has to be responsible as a defender and not just leave his hands below his weight.
So far in Martinez's mature career, when things have gotten a little rough like this, he's been able to ratchet it up to another level athletically. Can he still at 38?
Governing body, which governs his fight, is using open scoring tonight. But the open scoring is not being given to the audience at large, rather just to the corner. Between rounds, they gave the scores 40-36 Martinez, 39-37, 39-37 also Martinez, so he has a 2 or 3 point lead on all three scorecards. Harold, how do you have it so far?
Okay, sir. I've got it 40-36 as well. Sergio Martinez circling and landing an up jab constantly. Just hits him with the up jab all night. Here's it, man. You know, I think Martin Morris is not aggressive enough. He's got to get off more. Has to throw more punches. The fourth round was close. I thought Martinez won it. But Jim, in case of a controversy, they will go to an instant replay. But bear in mind, we may not have any controversy. Any controversies tonight.
Good left hand.
Left hand upstairs by Martinez. Murray landed a good body shot by Harry with delivering the score.
And now's the danger for Murray, that he's had some success and he's starting to open up. He'll be more susceptible to Martinez's speed and power.
Oh, good right hand.
Hard right hand by Murray.
Yes, Murray.
One development in Martinez's career, he's been getting hit considerably more often over the course of the last 4 or 5 fights. Once again, their heads come together, and once again, Barabecchio has something to say to both fighters about it.
Okay.
Now he wants Martinez to keep him up.
Good body shot by Murray.
Martinez was landing the left upstairs while Murray landed the more solid body shot. Good right hook inside by Martinez.
Murray's having a lot of success with that right to the body in this round.
Right around the guard for Martinez.
Talking about. You can't give him that round. He got him up, but you can't give him that round. We knew that.
Beautiful.
You better?
Yeah. Spit, Johnny.
Yep. Spit bucket.
I'm happy.
This side here, mate.
We have 3 points on the target and 1-4.
3 points on one score and 4 on the other.
All
right, come on. Just keep working it that way. Everything okay? Keep working with the hand. And don't hold back. Keep working, Sergio. Everything okay? Okay, good. Breathe.
We mentioned that one recent trend in Martinez's career is getting hit more and more. Another has been difficulties in the middle rounds of several fights. He seems to have a tendency to drift in the middle rounds and then turn it on down the stretch of the fight. In the last 2 rounds, the fourth and the fifth, Murray combined to outland Martinez 25-17 with the punch tap numbers in those 2 rounds.
Good right here by Murray.
Martinez is the middleweight champion of the world, the lineal champ. And usually when the champ fights the 10th contender or the 8th contender or the 5th contender, as Sergio's been doing in recent years, class will tell over time, and he takes over in the second half of the fight.
But
Murray's come out well here.
I think he might be bleeding outside the left eye. Difficult from our angle to see this at this moment. There's a small speck of blood outside the left eye of Sergio Martinez. of the fight, we take you to Ontario, California, for the heavyweight showdown between Chris Arreola and Burmester Byrne. And that is now a full-scale trickle of blood outside Martinez's left eye.
Martinez has always used that hands-down technique because he's so slippery he can avoid punches and counter. But here, he's getting hit cleanly in the face, and it seems to be backfiring.
Because Murray's throwing more straight punches.
That is Sergio Martinez's father. An iron worker here again in Buenos Aires. He's here along with Sergio's two brothers and his mother and their mom. Right there. So the whole Martinez family trying to root their charge on after what appeared to be a difficult round against Murray.
Sergio, you gotta be careful, Sergio. You gotta work here. Work him, work him. Let your hands go, Sergio.
Come on.
Breathe now. I'm good, okay. You gotta do it. You're doing a good job.
Here you see the little head collision, I think that may have caused the cut. Couldn't really see much there. After that is when he started to rub his eye. So maybe that was a small headbutt.
Albia Box numbers in the six, that was all Murray. Martinez was 10 of 46, Murray 22 of 60, landing at a pretty good connect percentage. And Martinez kept motioning Murray in, trying to get him to open up. Murray took advantage and landed several good, clean body shots.
Once to the head weren't that bad either.
Good hook. Good hook by Martinez.
Has a very good cut, man. Dr. Roger Anderson from out in Santa Barbara County, California, where Martinez lives and works out in Oxnard, California. Anderson helped him through the Darren Barker fight when Barker broke his nose early in the fight, and it was bleeding and broken, and Martinez made it to the finish line and won the fight. Actually, with an 11th round knockout of Barker, cut over the left eye or around the left eye in three previous fights. So that's nothing new. Sometimes when a fighter is accustomed to being cut, it breaks up.
Rules, they take 1 point from the uncut fighter. In other words, if
so they try and even it up by subtracting a point from the guy who's not bleeding. Like, you know, it's a strange rule, but that's the rule outside the United States.
What you're saying is that Martin Murray will have a point deducted because of the bleeding on Martinez's eye.
You know, I don't think so. And the reason I say that is because the referee didn't give any indication that it was a headbutt. He didn't give any indication that he was going to take a point.
I don't think it was a headbutt at all, Jim. So if it had been a headbutt, I think he'd have taken a point. But that wasn't a headbutt.
Well, Martinez was responded like a proud champion, but very much like a 38-year-old proud champion.
Shoulder right here, I think, and that's what caused the problem. Wasn't the head, but it was the shoulder.
It was the punch landed first, followed by the follow-up shoulder.
Exactly.
About which Garabecchio spoke to Murray, but has not yet issued any point deduction of which we know. So it's a rough go so far for Sergio Martinez against Martin Murray as we come through the seventh round into the eighth.
Martinez is a sportsmanlike fighter, but not everybody adheres strictly to the marquee of Queensberry rules, especially in the middleweight division, and here he's finding that out.
Good 1-2 for Martinez, trying to get himself back in command in the fight. Last two rounds have been very good for Martin Murray.
Back, come back, come back. Okay, okay.
Martinez using a good right jab, a good stiff right jab.
Good left hook by Murray. Right on the jaw of Martinez. Mostly it's been a Martinez round up to that moment. And that was a solid shot for Murray. Down goes Martinez on a straight right hand.
Three, four,
he's been knocked
five,
down now in four of his last five fights.
Seven, eight. Okay, seven.
That wasn't just one right hand. That was an accumulation of shots. One guy has his hands up, and the other has his hands down.
Oh, good left hand.
So that sets up the probability of a two-point round. They begin to look very English. As we mentioned at the beginning, Murray's the larger man, clearly the true middleweight in the ring, and increasingly that size advantage seems to be a problem for Martinez.
And Martinez is bagging straight back from the straight right hand, which
back,
is not a good idea,
okay,
Jim.
Okay.
When you bag straight back from the straight right, you're usually going to run right into it. And that's how he got knocked down. He bagged straight up from the straight right hand.
So far, Murray has taken what? Barker and... Macklin have done to Martinez, and he's improved on the game plan. And it looks, to my eye, as though he's fighting a somewhat diminished Martinez.
talking about. I don't know why I didn't give him a count for that. That was a punch. Deep breath. I've got it, Johnny. You just put loads of Vaseline on him.
Yeah.
Deep breath.
Gaitrain, please.
In a minute.
Yes, please.
PC, Martin come forward with a jab. Martinez going straight back, and that straight right hand landed right on the pipe. Knocked him down, more off balance shot than anything, but the fact that he's back, directly back from him, allowed Martin to throw the straight right down the pipe and knock Martinez off balance. Good knockdown call by the ref.
No, okay.
Same thing. Good, let's go. Nice bag on the face.
Once again, Sergio Martinez has struggled in the middle rounds. Once again, he has been knocked to the canvas, just the way Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. knocked him down, and Matthew Macklin knocked him down in his last two fights prior to this.
That right hand, he was softened up by a lot of those clean shots to the body and head. And as Martinez has shown more vulnerable, he's gotten more popular. But he's got a win here, and he's in jeopardy of losing.
Mark Murray fans might be shocked to know that given this governing body's open scoring system, the corners get the scores between rounds after the fourth and the eighth. The scores after the eighth, 77-74, 76-75, 76-75, all for Martinez, not for Murray. Harold, how do you have it?
I've got it 76-75, Sergio Martinez. But to tell you the truth, Bob Murray's coming on. I mean, he easily won the last three rounds, got an extra point for the knockdown. So, you know, it's a very close fight to this point, but the momentum is with Murray.
So Martinez may appear to need a late round rally, and that has been one of his trademarks too. How many late round rallies can a 38-year-old fighter produce?
Well, you don't know, but Martin has kept his hands at home a lot this round. Martinez made him use his hands for defense for most of the round, so he hasn't been able to really land any good shots so far in this particular round.
That's true, but as a result, Murray is not being hit cleanly, and from time to time, Martinez is.
Good body shot there by Martin Murray. Martinez has been more active in the round.
I dare to have the right hand.
Another hard right hand for Murray.
Martinez is blocked and Murray is not.
I remind you that as soon as this fight is concluded, we will take you to Ontario, California for a terrific heavyweight matchup between exciting American Chris Areola, who throws a lot of punches, and hard-punching Berman Stubern. He has one-punch knockout power.
It's not too bad for excitement here, Jim. Murray's long nose is starting to bleed. From all the
That's right. Blood trickling from the nose of Martin Murray.
Back. The back. No,
possible comeback round for Martinez.
Okay,
might need to put a finishing touch on it right here. And he gets a straight left hand in to punctuate the round. 8:25, tune in at 6:15 p.m. for the Carl Brach-Nico Kessler rematch live from London, England, later that night. We'll re-air Brach versus Kessler, as well as the live 175-pound showdown between Jean-Pascal and Lucien Boutte in Montreal.
No problem.
It's all right.
Sergio,
you gotta move. Move with the jab. Move to the left, Sergio. And don't stay there. Two jabs and finish it off, all right? Double it. The left. Here.
Come on,
it's going on the 10th. Come on, Sergio, please. Work the jab, Sergio. Let's go.
Albion Box numbers again found a significant advantage in the round for Murray. Right now, I can just hear Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. saying, see, I took everything away from him and left him with nothing. And Harold Letterman's scorecard now even as he gave the ninth round to Murray.
Even as Martinez,
three rounds to go.
Even as Martinez was getting hit
watch
in that
your
last
answer,
round.
Watch your answer, watch your answer. Watch your answer. Okay, watch your answer.
You could see he was feeling himself more in that round, getting a little more of a rhythm going and feeling better about himself.
Bigger, stronger Martin Murray having things his way from the middle rounds through this point against Sergio Martinez in a fight which is now even on Harold Letterman's scorecard and perhaps on a couple of other scorecards as well.
This will come down to Martin Murray's conditioning, Jim. If he's conditioned good, he can make for a good finish here.
No pants. Break, no pants. Okay, break, no pants.
Short shallow punch, followed by a hook. Then a straight right hand right there, which grazed him, and Martinez went down. Now, it was a grazing shot, wasn't the best of a punch, and it could have been the feet work, the footwork that got tangled up that caused him to go down.
Martinez is so good at moving his head that he complained earlier in the fight that Murray hit him on the back of the head. But that should be ruled a knockdown.
Yes.
Because the only reason it landed on the back of the head is that Martinez was moving his head.
Exactly.
The only possible reason that wasn't a knockdown, and our camera angle did not show it, could have been that Murray's foot was on top of Martinez's foot, and the referee chose to rule it a slip for that reason. Power punches in the last three rounds. Martinez has landed 20. Murray has landed 52 by CompuBox count. Sergio Martinez has produced late-round magic in his career. Had trouble with Matthew Macklin, knocked him out the 11th. Had trouble with Darren Barker, knocked him out the 11th.
Having trouble
with Martin Murray.
With Martin Murray, Jim, and it's the 11th.
Thank you. That jab has really come alive and saved Martinez. The jab is throwing all of Martinez off his home. That same jab caused Sergio a lot of problems in this fight with Martinez. Good body shot.
Body shot by Martinez. Murray missing with the right hand. Martinez needs a rally and a demonstrative one.
The kind of quiet round that does not serve Martin Murray right now.
Martinez slipping and moving, occasionally landing a shot. Murray looking to try to seal the deal. Reaches for another big right hand.
Murray admitted he didn't do enough against Felix Sternweight to deserve to win. He got a draw. Is he doing enough right now?
He went to Germany and almost upset Stern. Now he comes to Argentina and for the moment appears to have the upper hand against Martinez.
But he may be letting this round slip away.
Yeah, I wouldn't say he has the upper hand, but he's doing pretty good.
Well, if Martinez won that round, it could have been useful medicine at exactly the right moment. But we've got a fight which appears to be on the table going to the 12th.
Murray's the guy who's done the punishing.
Sergio's the last one. Leave it up. Work and move. Work and move.
Okay.
Right, Sergio? Work and work. Which hands? Left hand. Left hand hurts a lot.
Last time, Marty. Fight for your life, mate. It's all here now. 12th last round.
Martin, everything. Bring your kids, lad. Come on, man.
Stand up for
me. Change your life forever, man.
Be careful. Bing, bing. Stop letting him do that.
Well, you heard the discussion of a potentially damaged left hand in Martinez's corner. He fought from the fourth round on against Chavez with a broken left hand. Off your box numbers in the 11th. Martinez 16 at 62. Murray 14 at 52. First time that Martinez has outlanded Murray since the seventh round.
And the middleweight championship of the world looks like it's up for grabs at the moment.
Shot by Martinez.
Sticking the left hand into Murray's belly. Trying to do it again.
Martinez with a left. Martinez done for the second consecutive middleweight title fight? What he had to do in the 12th round to keep his title?
Quite possibly. Look at that. 50% of you believing Martinez has won, and 50% of you believing Murray has won. Was the second incident in which Martinez appeared to go to the canvas as the result of a Murray punch. We thought it could have been ruled a knockdown. The governing body which sanctions this fight is using instant replay to their great credit. They looked at the replay and decided to agree with the referee that it was a slip.
I have no comment.
Harold, very quickly, tell us the judges who are scoring the fight.
Okay, Jim, the three judges scoring the fight, Max DeLuca, one of my favorite judges from California, as you see at Roberto Guerrero, Andre Berto, does a good job all the time. Nicolas Hidalgo, that does from Caracas, Venezuela. He works a lot outside the country, doesn't work much inside the country. I hope he'll do a good job. Alejandro Rochin, an outstanding judge, comes from Chula Vista, California. He always works, you know, in Mexico and in California. Works a lot. Good judge.
All right, let's go to Michael Buffer and find out how they scored it.
Damas y caballeros, ladies and gentlemen, we go to the judges' scorecards. Los tres jueces, Alejandro Rochin, Max DeLuca, y Nicolas Hidalgo, scores 115 to 112, all three cards. The winner, the Quilmes Argentina still WBC middleweight champion of the world, Sergio Maravilla.
Sergio Martinez. Roy Jones mentioned stamina, and whether stamina was a factor or not, the judges decided that Murray did not do enough in the late rounds to seal the deal.
Yeah, stamina was the key. The last two rounds, really, to me, decided the victory of the fight. I felt like Martinez came out and showed far more stamina in those last two rounds than did anybody else.
And final copy box numbers will probably reflect mostly the big rally for Murray in the middle part of the fight. You see he winds up with a 26-punch edge in landed punches. He throws 43 more and winds up with a significantly higher connect percentage in the fight than Sergio Martinez. Our punches, an even bigger edge for Murray. Landing 41 more, throwing 60 more, landing at a 6% higher percentage. Again, he bunched a lot of that into the rounds between the fifth and the tenth. In the first four or five rounds, Martinez was in control. In the last two rounds, he swept them on all three scorecards to win the fight. And there are the punch zone numbers that show you where the punches landed for both Murray and Martinez. And you see how Murray was able to use both his right and left hands upstairs, landing 107 punches in the area of the head. Martinez, a lot of right hooks. The right hook was by far his best punch in the fight. And you heard the discussion in Martinez's corner about a damaged left hand. His promoter, Lou DiBella, has come over to us since the fight ended and pointed to the right knee, indicating that Martinez may have damaged the knee again. You fight on a rainy night in a wet ring, and you run the risk of having more injuries.
Yeah, you do that slipping ring, you knew would cause some problems, so that was definitely going to be a factor once you knew the rain was going to reside tonight.
He needs water. He needs water.
And now let's go to Max Kellerman with the winner and still the middleweight champion, Sergio Martinez.
Sergio, congratulations. Before we even get to the fight, what was this like in front of 45,000 cheering Argentines?
Lo más espectacular de toda mi vida, lo más maravilloso, lo más hermoso que pude haber vivido en toda mi vida.
It was the most fantastic thing, the most marvelous thing I could have ever experienced as a sportsman.
Did you feel added pressure to put on a show for these fans, fighting with your hands down from the very first round?
No, no, no sufro presión. La presión a mí me hace sentir más fuerte. De hecho, hoy subí a divertirme y así lo hice. Me golpeé la mano muy feo, la mano izquierda. Me duele muchísimo. Una fisura, una fractura.
No pressure, no pressure. I build with pressure. I enjoy pressure. And I wanted to have a great show. But today, I hurt my hand. I hurt my left hand. And I might be broken.
What does it mean, do you think, that for the second consecutive fight, you kept the middleweight championship of the world by doing what you had to do in the 12th and final round?
Es quedarme un poquito más en la memoria de todos y escribir un poquito más fuerte mi nombre en la historia del boxeo mundial.
It burns my name in the people's memory and it makes my name even greater in boxing history.
Did you think the fight was up for grabs in the 12th round?
No, no, sabía que yo iba ganando, a pesar de que me dolía mucho la mano, a pesar de que sabía que caí en el octavo, sé que iba ganando la pelea con claridad.
No, I knew that I was winning. I knew that I was winning clearly. But my hand was hurting since the eighth round.
Okay, you're 38 years old, and you finally become a big superstar. But you're coming off knee surgery. You hurt your hand again tonight. It was a very rough fight. What is in your immediate future?
El futuro es trabajar para recuperarme, pero las superestrellas somos así, nos recuperamos siempre ante todo.
We have to work to get better, but the superstars are like that. We always get better against any odds.
Thanks, champ, and congratulations once again.
Thank you, viva Argentina.
Jim.
All right, back live at ringside with Roy Jones.